question is, are we a finite non-zero commutative ring with a unity? Then which of following is necessary? First option is, any non-zero element of R is either unit or zero divisor. Second option is, there may exist a non-zero element of R which is neither unit nor zero divisor. Third one is, every prime ideal of R is maximal. And fourth one is, if R has no zero divisor, then order of any additive subgroup of R is prime power. So let's start with option 1. So option 1 is, any non-zero element of R is either unit or zero divisor. So let A be any non-zero element. Then define f a function from R to R such that f of x equal to ax. First case, if f is 1, 1, implies f must be on 2 because R is a finite CRU. Implies there exists x belongs to R such that ax equal to 1 implies a must be unit. So if this mapping is 1, 1, then a must be unit. Second is, if f is not 1, 1, then there exists x, y belongs to R such that x, y not equal to R, x not equal to y and ax equal to ay implies a into x minus y is 0, x minus y is non-zero, a is non-zero, implies a must be a zero divisor. That is, every non-zero element is either unit or a zero divisor. So first option is true. Now if first option is true, then second option must be incorrect. Now for third option, in every finite CRU, every prime ideal is always maximal. So direct statement, third option is always true. And fourth one, if R has no zero divisor, that is R is an integral domain and the cardinality of finite integral domain is never divisible by two distinct prime numbers. Hence, every additive subgroup of R is some prime power. So fourth option is also correct. Hence, answer is second, third, and fourth.